Some of the design projects that I undertake involve me designing the product and then manufacturing. In this case, about 200 vacuum form panels. Let's take a look at how you design and then fabricate for such a project. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button too, in case you haven't already done so. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. When you start designing a product, it's often good to know exactly what manufacturing process you're going to use so that you can design to that process. I start this project just like I would any other one, in an ideation phase where I'm creating a bunch of different ideas of what these panels could look like. We'd stumbled upon this nice sort of simple, elegant, kind of half pill shape. I even did an early mock-up where I cut some Ren tools and vacuum formed on top of that, really simply to see what that looks like. Now, one of the hidden features of this product is that it has this special little hanger, and this hanger allows it to be hung from either direction, and there's even a little notch that allows it to be hung on, let's say, a pin or a nail in a studio environment. So it's a little detail that you don't see, but can be hugely beneficial to the client in the long run. Here's some of the other variations of that shape and the different flat spots that they have at the top. And ultimately, we even did one where the hangers were on the outside. We didn't go with that. At some point, you gotta make a tool. What you're gonna vacuum form on. Here's a quick little sketch, something I could share with the tool maker. And then I have to make the CAD data of the actual tool that's gonna be cut by the CNC machinist. You'll notice it has a couple little notches in the four corners. They're registration marks, and those are gonna become important and helpful for later on in the manufacturing process. This is the final rendering, just so the tool maker can see what's going on and what the tool looks like, also for the client. This is the CNC milled aluminum part. One half here is sanded, now the other side is sanded, and it involves me benching out and sanding everything by hand. When you vacuum form parts, they need vent holes, and here I am just drilling out the vent holes. Check out how my electric drill causes the video to wobble. Now that I've finished benching the tool and getting it ready for vacuum forming, I can focus my attention on all the little hanger parts, and those are going to be laser cut. I'm certainly not going to cut those by hand. Here's my material, already cut to size. I'm using a PETG clear material. It's easy to form and economical. Here you can see the tool being raised into the plastic PETG. It fits nicely, and I can form two parts at a time. All right, back to those hanger pieces. Well, those hanger pieces all need to get glued on to a sloping edge on the back side of these formed parts. So I route the one edge so that it can mate up with the formed part. Now, in this case, all the formed parts have been laser cut. I send this out to a local laser cutter. It's outside the capability of what I could do. But those registration holes, those registration pins that were sticking up on the tool that I talked about earlier, were important for laser cutting and aligning. So they're able to basically come through with a laser cutter and cut all these pieces out. Here, I'm solvent bonding the hangers in place. I've made some forms or some jigs that hold the hanger in place, and they're just made out of cardboard, and these are also laser cut. They're my templates for gluing everything together. Here I glue the pieces on. I just let them dry. Once they're dry, I can pull them off the templates and then add the little hanger pieces on the side for support. The parts are pretty big, and the thing that nobody ever thinks about is the packaging and the shipping of these parts, because ultimately they gotta go from me, they gotta be painted, they gotta be transported to the show and back again into some warehouse. So great to provide that as something additional that your client can really benefit from. If you liked the video and you found it useful, smash that thumbs up button and leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.